Hey there, Parkridge kids. Welcome to STEWY'S music lesson of the week. Yeah. Hi everyone, it's the last week of term 3, week 10. So let's get straight on with it. For our part 1, you will notice something different. We're going to revise long and short sounds, which is pretty much rhythm, because that's all rhythm is putting together long and short sounds mixed with silence, and then that sort of creates music. So you'll notice there's this sheet here, and there are 5 pieces, or 5 rhythms that I'm going to play on guitar in a moment, and they're going to be made up of just short and long sounds. Now you'll notice there's dots on the sheet. They are representing short sounds, so they'll probably sound like TTs. And then there's long dashes, which will sound more like tars. So there's 3 rhythm patterns to choose from, each in 4 beats per bar. So whatever I play on the guitar, I need you to listen carefully and choose which one of these rhythm patterns full of long and short sounds, dots and dashes, which was the one that I just played. So let's give it a go, yeah? We'll start with this first one here. I'll pop it in front of me on my music stand so I can see it, and hopefully you've managed to print yours out, or you can just identify it on the screen, on your seesaw at home. Here goes with the first one. Which one of the 3 am I playing here? Here we go. Have a think about it. I'll play it again. Hopefully that's long enough for you to choose. It was actually the middle one, just here. It goes dot, dot, dash, dot, dot, dash. That one there. Hopefully you got the right answer. Let's go for the second one. Which one of these rhythm patterns should I play? Here I go. I'll play it one more time. Hopefully you chose the first one there. I won't hold it up. I'll keep playing so the video doesn't take too long. So that was the first rhythm pattern for number 2. Let's move on to number 3. Here goes. I'll do it again. For number 3, the one I just played out of the patterns was the last one there, the third one, which had dot, 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 dash, dash. Okay, 2 more to go. I'll do number 4 now. Here I go. I think that one's pretty easy. I'll do it one more time. That was the first one again for number 4. So that was the first pattern, dot, 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 dash. Or in other words, T, 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 tie, yeah? And now I'll do number 5. Which one should I do for number 5? Here goes, listening carefully. I'll play it one more time. Number 5 was also the first one just there. So hopefully that's a good bit of ear training for listening out for long and short sounds, which is another way of saying rhythm, really. That's it for part 1. For part 2, please just keep using Note Names for Kids or Star Fours to practice your notes. Now let's move on to part 3. So for part 3, we're talking a little bit more about tempo. Remember, tempo has to do with how fast, medium, or slow a particular song or piece of music is. And we use Italian terms to refer to each speed. So something that's slow is called largo or lento. have a listen to a beat that's largo or lento. It's around about 40, maybe 60 beats per minute. You move a little bit faster. In the middle there, they use the term moderato. So have a listen to that. Probably around 80, 90, maybe even getting up to 100 beats per minute. So it's faster than seconds. Then we get to allegro, which is fast. And that's around about 120 beats per minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the fastest is prestissimo, which is 208 beats per minute. Have a listen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you probably could go faster, but that's generally the fastest term in music that gets used, because I think some instruments would struggle to play any faster than that. So you might also want to check out the link that I've put there, the YouTube link, that will explain fast and slow music in a different way to what I have done just then. So all I need you to do, once you've had a listen or a view of that, have a go at doing this sheet here. We've got some fast and slow objects. Think pictures of things that would make either a fast or a slow sound. All you need to do, maybe color them in, cut it out, make it look fantastic. And if you think it's fast, pop it in the fast column there. If you think it would make a slow sound, pop it in the slow column. And that's it. Let's do the very last part of our lesson for the week. Finally, for the very last thing, we're going to, similar to last week, listen to five pieces of music. And using the sheet that I've included in your package, exactly the same as last week's, there's a turtle for slow, a rabbit for fast, and a picture of both for medium. You need to decide whether the music that you're listening to has a fast, medium, or slow tempo. Have a listen to the first one. That one there was slow. Check it out when I tap in time. One, one, two, three, four. Nice and slow there. Not the slowest, but definitely in lento territory. Okay, here's the next song, song two. Is it fast, medium, or slow? Definitely loud. That one's pretty easy, yeah. That's fast for sure. Have a listen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. A band called Motorhead. That's their song called The Ace of Spades. They're a very loud band in their day. Okay, we're up to number three, fast, medium, or slow. Hopefully you can hear that, might turn it up a bit. Now, I wonder what you put for that answer. It's a classical piece of music, and it actually is very fast. It's probably a faster tempo than that heavy metal Ace of Spades song that I played just before. Keep listening. Here's the tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So as you can hear, that's a really fast one, a very famous piece of classical music called The Flight of the Bumblebee there. Two to go. Oh, here's one of my favorite bands. Be hard to hear the beat just yet. Mm-hmm. hopefully for that one, you circled or colored in the turtle for slow. Have a listen. Called Radiohead. Maybe mums and dads might have heard of them. I really like that band. Okay, here's the last one. Another good band that I like, Creedence Clearwater's Revival. Let's see, is it fast, medium or slow? The very last one. Great song, and I would say that's a moderate or medium tempo. Have a listen again. It's getting a little bit fast, but it still would be classed as a moderato tempo. So that is it for all of Term 3's learning. I hope you've enjoyed all the work we've done this term. Thank you very much to everyone who has sent work in. It's been great to see the excellent work that you have all been doing. Fingers crossed, I think after one more week of remote learning in Term 4, by week 2 of Term 4, we'll be back at school and almost back to normal. So I'll see you either in the next clip or back at school. Bye for now. That's right.